football in class. We are continuing the class from where we stopped. Today we will be talking about bipolar transistors. There are actually two types of transistors. We will have virtually two types. We have field effect, that is FET transistors, and then the bipolar transistors. These are one of the most common. And they are actually, if you remember, they are actually based on junction diodes. Together, we have some junctions like that. So, for what we are going for. So, now we are going to bipolar transistors. Where transistors are actually made up of junctions of diodes. We have the NPN, the FPN version, we have the AFP version, things like that. So, we'll get to that. Now, these bipolar transistors are developed by UK scientists, Bradley and Bradley. Transistor is made from single silicon wafer. We do actually make a transistor from different materials, like the doped material, N-doped, P-doped, and N-doped. Don't bring two different materials together. You actually use a single wafer, and then you dope this part as N, dope this part as P, so this part as N to form NPN, or this part as PNN. Not different materials together, but a single wafer. Now, we have three regions at both, and then you have the transistor. The NPN transistor, this is where you dope the first region as N type, second region as P type, and then like that. So, not put them, it's not like you put them together, but they are also on a particular wafer, and you have to form transistor. Now this is the way it is actually done, as if on the wafer. And then you have the leading part is the base. Leading part is the base, and then this other form, this pistol part can form the collector, and then the other will form the emitter. Now the schematic diagram, as if you are drawing on the circuit, is how this is how it will be. The pointing arrow outwards shows that it's actually the emitter. The other side is the collector, and then we have this one little part as the base. Now, this is the NPN version, and then the arrow is pointing inwards, which is the DNP version. And this is the diagram of the typical transistor that you commonly find in the market, in the stores. Now, for both two transistor types, the base is highly doped compared to collector and the emitter, and the base is thinness, and then to find micrometer thing. So we have that, and then the major thing about transistor is that it switches on at a particular voltage called the threshold voltage. When the threshold voltage is reached, then the transistor switches on this way. So we apply a voltage here, and the voltage is actually up to the threshold voltage. Sometimes it's around 2.5 volts. We'll discuss that later, around 0.5, 0.6, 0.2, and so on, different, but most common is 0.6. Once you apply a voltage that's over 0.6, or exactly at 0.6, this current here flow this way. So if you have anything that is less than 0.6, it will not flow. Once it is up to 0.6 or above, the current will not flow. E.g., value, for example, the transistor is actually for switching signals. You want to switch the transistor, you want to switch a signal converting from analog to digital, transistor is actually used. And then it's like the gate in the FET. For FET, it's like the gate, for this case, the base. 4.6 volt transistor made for silicon wafer. Silicon is not connected for as long as the signal at the base the transistor is still there. Now, let's discuss the base emitter formulation. Current at the emitter is equal to the current at the base plus the current at the collector. The current at the emitter here is the summation of this current and this current. The voltage of the base is actually the 0.6 volts. Once the voltage of the base is 0.6 volts, it can be more than 0.6 volts, but this is the voltage of the base. This is the voltage of the collector base, This is the voltage collector emitter, collector base. So, So these are the major points about traffic. So the base emitter junction is called bias, and then the base collector junction is also is reverse bias. So when transistor is off, then the when transistor is off, that means that the VBD, the 0.6 volt, is the voltage that you goes is less than 1.6. When transistor is on, then it forms, it means that that voltage is more than 0.6 volt. That is the reason why we have 0.1. That is why we have transistor to be 1 and 0 logic. That is the principle of 1 and 0 logic. So that is the foundation, and then hopefully next class we will be discussing the transistor circuit. And where we have this diagram, this one is actually biasing, we will discuss biasing and everything like that. So now see the reapplication of logic circuits made of transistor. So thank you, class.